For there are certain men crept in unawares, who were before of old ordained to this condemnation, ungodly men, turning the grace of our God into lasciviousness, and denying the only Lord God and our Lord Jesus Christ.
Speaking of diversity, you know, New York City, one thing that is polarizing to some communities, especially within religion, is homosexuality and the debate around it. I mean, how do you balance those two things? I mean, are people of all sexual orientations welcome, and how do you see that?
Absolutely. I think what I was referring to there was, you know, some people would be like, you need to make bet, you need to answer our questions about the homosexuality issue. And I always say, I do, you just don't like my answers. And here's exactly what I mean by that. Some media wants us to use our pulpit to have a soapbox for social issues. I don't believe that's our job. I don't believe Jesus did that. I don't believe Jesus did that. Go look at what Jesus did. He was always talking about the heart of an individual and the soul of a person, not these symptomatic societal problems. And people hate that because a lot of churches are about what they're against. We're about what we're for. Because a lot of churches are about what they're against. We're about what we're for. And when it comes to people's sexuality, I don't want to use a public forum to talk about private things, because how in the world can you have a dialogue? How in the world can I hear your story? How in the world can someone have a question? So if I stand up in a pulpit and I just start railing at something or make a statement in a newspaper about something, I believe it's insensitive to the journey that people are walking on. And our church is going to protect people no matter where you're from, no matter what you carry, no matter what kind of orientation you feel like is your lane of life to run in, no matter what you carry, no matter what kind of orientation you feel like is your, lane of life to run in.
Matthew chapter 6 is a setup prayer. Jesus was setting people up. Church in the wild. And there's this phrase, I'm going to read it from the message. It's not a direct translation, it's a paraphrase. But it's good. It makes a lot of sense. Here's what he said. Our Father in heaven, reveal who you are. Set the world right. Do what's best. As above, so below. As above, so below. As above, so below.
But to the fearful and unbelieving and the abominable and murderers and whoremongers and sorcerers and idolaters and all liars shall have their part in the lake which burneth with fire and brimstone, which is the second death.